Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you how to secure TLS configuration. So let's get started. TLS, or Transport Layer Security, is a cryptographic protocol used all over the internet to secure communication between different parties. It's an advanced encryption standard that provides the necessary level of protection for secure online exchanges. How security TLS is configured is paramount to organizations and individuals' overall cybersecurity framework. The Transport Layer Security Certificate is the most ubiquitous security protocol today. Its purpose is to provide a solid layer of security for online exchanges between two parties, including between a client and a web server. While in the past, using a protocol was not obligatory, nowadays, it is central to the security of digital communications. For example, search engines determine whether a website uses a security protocol in its search engine rankings. Browsers also indicate when a website is insecure, warning users to avoid it. Security protocols over the years. Previously, it was the Secure Sockets Layer protocol, but it is now considered insufficient security. That's why it is not in use anymore. The Transport Layer Security protocol itself has had different versions over the years. Earlier versions, 1.0 and 1.1, are not deemed secure enough, so they should be avoided. The general recommendation is to use Transport Layer Security versions 1.3 or 1.2 at the moment. It's best to opt in for TLS 1.3 since it removes old cryptography and reduces the risk of some types of cyber attacks. However, this is not always applicable to some types of organizations. New iterations are being released regularly, so the rule of thumb is to stick to the latest security updates. The importance of certificate authorities. Certificate authorities, or CAs, are organizations that have the legitimacy and public trust to issue certificates. This makes choosing a trustworthy CA central to ensuring your digital assets security, and, more specifically, the protection you get through the Transport Layer Security Protocol. Some of the things to look out for include the following. The CA wants to support security practices further. It addresses new vulnerabilities quickly and effectively. It provides technical support and on-time customer service. When selecting a CA, you'll need to configure your Certificate Authority Authorization, CAA. This way, you will authorize the respective CA to issue certificates for your domain. The role of private keys and their security. The Transport Layer Security Protocol employs two types of keys for data encryption and authentication of users who can access it. These are the public key for external distribution and the private key, which should be kept securely. To get your X509v3 certificate signed by your CA, you generate your private key manually or through a tool. Then you send a certificate signing request, CSR, to your CA for signing. It's imperative to use strong private keys. The industry standards are the 2048-bit RSA with SHA-256 key or 256-bit ECDSA with SHA-256 on the P256 curve key. In addition, private keys have to be generated only by you. It's also a good idea to renew certificates often. They usually have a validity of 13-12 months, plus an extra rollover month. It's best to do the renewal even before the certificate expiry. If certificates have a shorter period of validity, it may be handy to opt in for automated renewal to ensure accurate certificate management. Another important tip is to revoke all certificates if you suspect a breach of your certificates. A good practice is also to monitor certificate transparency logs to detect in case of certificates that have quickly been issued outside of your control. A correctly configured TLS encryption ensures that users only get consent from your web application. This means there is no unregulated tampering with the exchanged communication, and users cannot eavesdrop through the Transport Layer Security Protocol. It is paramount to configure the Transport Layer Security Protocol correctly to ensure the real security of your systems. If this is not done, this may create a sense of security that is not backed in reality. One of the main aspects of TLS configuration is using suitable profiles. Internet organizations recommend profiles, and following them is a good practice. Legacy profiles for TLS 1.1 and 1.0 have been found to have a lot of vulnerabilities. You should set up a migration plan to replace them with new versions. How to check your TLS security settings for optimal security. In your TLS configuration, you should set the allowed Transport Layer Security Protocol version and ciphers to the most up-to-date values, which are considered secure now. First and foremost, it's essential to disable all older versions of the Transport Layer Security Protocol. such as TLS 1.1 and 1.0. It's also a good idea to disable features that have proven to be insecure. More specifically, it's best to disable insecure renegotiation, insecure protocol downgrade, record compression, export key generation, and support for SSL2. As for TLS 1.3, it is advised not to use the zero round-trip mode or zero RTT. If it's enabled, clients can send data in a transport layer security session before the complete TLS handshake. This can give way to replay attacks and other security vulnerabilities. So it's best to avoid zero RTT mode, unless application protocols have specific protection for replay attacks. You can check out the TLS configuration proposal offered by Mozilla, or use the SSL config generator. For secure TLS configuration, it's crucial to use vital and trusted certificates, as described in our guide Configure Trusted Certificates. Here are a few handy tips for server certificate configuration that we recommend you keep in mind. Opt in for the latest SSL TLS protocol. Currently, modern versions 1.3 or 1.2 of the Transport Layer Security Protocol exist. Check if you have any intermediate certificates. If you do, install them on your server so browsers get a full certification path. Ensure that your certificate applies to all of your hostnames. Use TLS implementations with AES cipher variants rather than older versions with weak ciphers like DES. Opt in for TLS session resumption to skip constant session key renegotiation. Enable forward secrecy FS, also known as perfect forward secrecy PFS, to protect past session keys in case a private key is compromised. Select secure cipher suites. Recommended cipher suite requirements are a minimum of 128-bit encryption. Below are our guides for configuring the SSL TLS encryption for your web server for Apache and Nginx. Apache. In the case of Apache, the SSL TLS configuration is stored in etc. Apache 2, mods enabled sluconf. If you use Let's Encrypt, the configuration may reside in etc. Let's Encrypt options SSL Apache conf. To enable only acceptable cipher suites with high encryption and current protocol set. Then it would be best if you reloaded the Apache server configuration for the new settings to take effect. Note that this action limits the eligible default cipher suites and protocol versions to recent transport layer security versions, which might lead users with older browsers to lose access. For Nginx, update the configuration file, which is usually located at etc. Nginx, jinsconf etc. Nginx, cited enabled, yoursite.com Ubuntu Debian, or, etc. Nginx, conf jinsconf rhel centos. Add the following directive to the server section. Then it would help if you restarted the Nginx server. Note that this limits the cipher suites and protocol versions to recent transport layer security versions. Users with older browsers may lose access. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.